Hello and welcome to Mile High Reefers. I'm Scott Anderson, and here's my new and improved quarantine system.
Here's the new quarantine setup, and it's a 29-gallon tank with a hang-on back filter, which right now doesn't even have filter media and a couple power heads in it, and some gravel on the bottom. So one of the big problems I've had, and I think a lot of you have had with quarantine setups, is maintaining water quality. Most people do their quarantine setup, it's completely bare bottom, and you're constantly doing large water changes to maintain water quality. And there's just no other way around it, right? Because there's no good filtration method for a quarantine setup. I have put sand in the bottom of mine. This is the sand out of the 55-gallon tank that I was using for a quarantine before. And that gives me a basic nitrogen cycle. So basically, I'm not poisoning my tank with ammonia. I do have the ability for the ammonia to turn from ammonia to nitrite to nitrate. And that keeps the tank from poisoning itself. Now, there is the potential that if I ever do get a sick fish and have to dose copper medication, that I will wipe that nitrogen cycle out. All that bacteria in there is potentially sensitive to the copper medication. I've heard both stories, and you'll see guys with fish-only tanks dose copper medication all the time with very little effect on it, and yet you'll hear other people say that it'll completely destroy the nitrogen cycle. I've never actually had to dose copper medication because I've been really lucky and I've bought healthy fish, and the one time that I've dealt with ick, I've taken the fish out and he actually didn't have to have any medication, which was cool. But nonetheless, whenever you get a new fish, you've got to quarantine them. As you'll see, I've got a purple tang in there and four chromies, and that is way more than you would put into a normal 29-gallon tank with good filtration. I mean, nobody in their right mind would put a purple tang in a 29-gallon tank for the long term. Now, this guy's in here just to make sure that he's happy and will spend no more than a month in here unless there are issues with his health. But still, I have to be able to maintain good water quality in my quarantine tank, because what good is a quarantine tank if I kill my fish before I get him into the main display? So in this tank, I have a old school heater. I don't even remember the brand at this point, and it's been working for years. And then I've got two MaxiJet 1200 power heads, and that's just to provide circulation. I believe that circulation is really important to fish health, as it keeps them moving, it keeps them exercising. And I also have this hang-on back filter, which is providing a lot of top agitation and also gives me the ability to put carbon in there if I need to, and the filter media if I decide to in the future. But still, the main method of maintaining good water quality is lots of water changes in this tank. So with that in mind, I've really thought long and hard about the best way to do this, and I decided to make this thing really easy. I mean, really super easy. So you can see that MaxiJet 1200 right there. That pump is actually in there to suck water out of the tank. So for my water change, all I have to do, and you'll have to forgive the wiring because none of this is permanent, because none of the tank setup is permanent, is shut this off, which shuts all of the pumps and the heater and everything off. And then there's a switch right here. I click that switch, and you can see the MaxiJet kicks on, and that starts sucking water out. So now that my pump's on, I'm gonna open this valve. This is a redundancy, as I have a four-year-old and other plans for this drain in the future. The water then goes down this drain, back behind all this junk, and down that drain. Once I've got enough water out of the tank for the desired water change, I shut that off, That shuts the pump off. Now, there's no siphon to worry about, as I've added this tube up the back, which basically is open and allows air to go in to stop any sort of siphon from happening. The long-term plan for this pipe is also to add a hose barb extension on there so that if I ever need to suck algae or something out of the main display, I can start the siphon with a power head and then have all of that go down the drain instead of trying to siphon into buckets. And with that in mind, I will also need this valve, which prevents my 4-year-old from actually starting up. It also prevents water from going back into the tank if I decide to suck stuff out of the main display upstairs. So then to get water back into the tank, I simply siphon water out of the main display up above. All that's left is to take pre-mixed salt water out of the bottom tank and drain it into the sump until the desired level is reached. So all that's left is to turn the pumps and heaters back on and my water change is complete. That was roughly 5 gallons, which is somewhere between 15 and 20% of this 29 gallon tank. And it was all really easy to do. I didn't have to carry a bucket. I didn't have to do any real hard work and it took less than 10 minutes. I also gave a water change to my main system. Granted, it's only 5 gallons out of 450, but definitely it's a benefit to the system. Now, what about daily maintenance? So like every other tank you're gonna work with, your quarantine tank is gonna evaporate, which means you're gonna have to go to the RODI filter and fill up some sort of container and dump it in your tank. Unless you do like I did, and that's run a line and a valve from your RODI system downstairs up here, so that all you have to do is turn the valve and you've got water to top off your tank. So for me, this system looks like it's gonna work out really well. I've torn down my 55 gallon tank, which was a pain to deal with, and I've installed this 29 gallon tank. The nice thing about the 29 gallon tank is my saltwater tanks downstairs are 30 gallons, which means in between quarantines, I can do 100% water change with the water I have on hand, which is hugely helpful. So when I went to set this tank up, it was no big deal to fill it up completely. So I recommend anybody who's setting up a quarantine tank to look at what you're doing and just make the ease of use as easy as possible. On my 55 gallon tank that I was using as quarantine, that's one of the things I failed with. It was difficult to do the water changes, it was difficult to top off, and therefore it didn't get done as much as it should have. This one, I shouldn't have that problem because it's all really easy to do. So thanks for watching this episode of Mile High Reefers, and I'll see you on the next one.